Yo! Hey, everybody! Yo. Welcome back to the Astralborn Beer Review.
Beer Review, yes!
We are super stoked because we're doing something we've been wanting to do for a while, and we tracked down a bunch of heavy metal band beers that were brewed for heavy metal bands.
That's right.
And they're very hard to find in Ohio.
That they are.
But they are.
We were able to get our hands on a few, and we're stoked to try them. Hopefully the beer is as good as the music, because to us, the beer is much more important.
It is. It is.
And good Mr. point. Cessna, why don't you start us off with beer number one? I don't even know what we're getting ourselves into tonight.
All right, guys. First up, we have the Motorhead Road Crew. So this is a play on the song, We Are the Road Crew, from the Ace of Spades album. Lemmy wrote this song as a tribute to his crew back when he was a roadie for Jimi Hendrix. Did you know he was a roadie for Jimi Hendrix?
No shit.
Did not.
I didn't know that at all.
So Road Crew is an American session pale ale. It's packed with hoppy citrus and black currant flavors, which delivers a crisp, refreshing, superior taste to celebrate the spirit of the song and those who inspired it.
There's a bunch of stuff floating around in there. A
lot of carbonation.
And there is a shitload of bubbles. It looks like a beer you'd see on like a cartoon. Yeah. I've never seen a beer Simpsons. Like that.
Yeah, well, cheers, boys. Let's put it in the test.
Let's hit it to Mr. Lemmy Kilmeister.
Kilmeister.
Bitter.
Not bad.
It's
got a soapy flavor.
Yeah, soapy.
A little bit.
It's got foam.
It's got some foam.
I don't know. I don't hate it. I think it's pretty okay. Mm. I've never had experience with heavy metal brewed beer. I don't know the...
Yeah, what's it supposed to be like?
I don't know.
Would Lemmy be proud of this beer?
Nothing to compare it to. I think he would. He's that older generation. My dad would love this.
Oh, your dad would, yeah.
He would kill that.
It's interesting.
I could drink a few of these.
Yeah. My ultimate question, would you buy it? Would you go back out there and buy a sixer of that?
No. I wouldn't. I mean, if it was,
yeah.
If you go to a restaurant and they only have like three craft beers on tap, and this is one of the three,
I would keep ordering it if I was already at a bar, yeah.
But I would not buy it again.
No.
It has nothing to do with Motorhead.
No.
No, not at all.
The beer is weird.
No offense to the Motorhead crew.
It's very sudsy.
Power.
Yeah.
It's like I'm in a laundromat.
I'm gonna be burping.
What is in this?
Lemmy's ashes.
I've had worse.
Well, I mean, if we're going by five, I would give it like a three.
I'll give it a three.
Three out of five.
I'll give
three.
It down the middle of the road, you know, it's just average. But, cheers.
I'm just trying to get this foam out of the bottom. It's like going to one of those soap raves.
And that original foam that you've seen on the top of my glass is still
stuck
in
to the
there.
Bottom.
It doesn't come out.
It's not whipped cream.
We're gonna need to rinse these boys out.
Yeah.
The next beer is Enter Night, which is the collaboration with Metallica and Stone Brewing. It's a crisp and refreshing pilsner that, much like the band, transcends genres, shatters preconceptions, and challenges convention.
Which is
That's a pretty good pitch.
That's a bold statement.
That's a pitch.
Contradicting to me, though.
Hold on. Before
we take challenge with a pilsner, how?
I don't think you can.
How's that breaking the mold?
Before we even take a sip, just knowing what Stone Brewery puts out,
it's
good shit.
I already feel like I know what this is going to taste like. Let's try it is.
All right,
let's try it is, boys. Let's try it is.
Cheers Ranch to Metallica. Cheers to Stone.
Ooh, what is that?
Grass.
Tastes like I just cut the grass. I got my white New Balances on, my jean shorts.
My new white balances are all ruined.
I don't. Pilsner to me is like a straight up Budweiser out of a can.
This is way too hoppy for a Pilsner.
I mean, it's not super bad. It's just like, how is that a Pilsner at all?
Do you think, I know Metallica like has mass appeal. They're like an arena band. Do you think if they were selling this at their shows that the majority of their fan base would enjoy this beer?
Yes.
You think so? I don't think so.
Really?
I
it seems like
so.
A beer that everybody could just drink.
I don't think so.
No,
it,
really.
It hits the back of your tongue and you're just like...
Yeah, man, I think this is like...
Is it too gnarly
for
touching the IPA end of the spectrum?
It's like a hoppy pilsner, but in a bad
way. None of us like hops that way. Like super gnarly hop bitter.
It's true. Damn, Paulie. You thirsty?
He's a thirsty boy.
Damn.
I can't even drink this shit.
I know, that's almost a sink pour for me.
Some things you do for the love of the band, okay?
Yeah, you're right.
Sometimes you buy the album when it's a bomber, just because you love Metallica. And on that note, please buy our album, because it's a bomber as well.
Yeah, it is.
Thank you.
You should buy it.
I would give this a 2. I don't like it.
I give it a 2.
1.5.
Derek dropping the bomb.
This one goes out to you, Metallica.
We still love you. Don't worry. Just don't like your beer.
Wow.
Well, you can't win them all.
Up next, we have Atu Limon, which is from Unibrew, from Quebec, Canada. This is brewed in honor of the friendship and mutual passions of Megadeth's Dave Mustaine and Unibrew's brewmaster, Jerry Veets. To all the friends of heavy metal, music, and Belgian-style ales in Quebec and throughout the world.
And to that I say, je m'appelle pas, j'adore bière. You don't like that?
That just hit me way different than the last one.
There's no hops to it.
No.
It tastes like a Belgian.
It is. It's exactly what it is.
Cat piss.
That's probably why I like it.
You like that shit?
I love it. It's it's drinkable.
No offense to Canadian beer.
I like Canadian beer.
Or Unibrew as a brewery. I know you guys like the style.
Jason hates Canada.
I don't hate Canada. I don't like Belgian styles, that's all.
See, I don't know. I don't get that cat pit. Is that like that cilantro thing that people have? Like, some people taste soap when they eat cilantro, and some people taste cat piss when they drink Belgians?
That must be it.
Or maybe I like cat piss.
I mean,
I like cat piss.
I'm not sure. I'm not ashamed to admit, this is good.
I'll say, this was better than the first two.
Yeah, really?
Yeah.
I would buy this again. I'm gonna give it like a, three point five.
All right, I'll give it a 2.5.
1. Here you go, buddy.
Hit me.
Derry!
I would have just drank it. Man, he foamed me.
He foamed you hard, Brody.
I like this. Thanks, Derek. I'm glad he hooked me up, buddy.
Thanks to the
he hates it. I love it. I don't know. I can't speak for why you
don't like Belgian beer. Something about it.
That's a good boy.
All right, guys. This next beer is another Megadeth collaboration with Unibrew. This is their Saison 13.
We got another one? Another Megadeth beer?
Which is a nod to Megadeth's 2011 album, 13, which I think was a stinker, if I remember. With its pale amber color and its red-orange hues, this beer is brewed with 13 carefully selected ingredients, described as a delicious Saison, offering the perfect combination of malt, fruitiness, and spice, punctuated by the fresh hop taste. Put them up, boys.
Cheers. I can smell it. I'm already going to like this by the smell. Yeah, that's a good one. I like that.
It's better than the other one.
It is better.
I give this a 3.75. 3.75.
3.75? Mm-hmm. Damn, man. You haven't just tasted it.
I did a palate cleanse.
Give me some of that shit.
You guys aren't cleansing the palate. You don't know what you're tasting. Derek looks like you're going to puke.
Mm. You all right, buddy?
Yeah, I'm good.
You ain't good. It's better than the other Megadeth beer, if I had to pick between the two.
It is better, but they're both good. I could drink both.
What makes this one better?
It's just got more of a flavor profile. It's got more going on.
It has more fruit flavor than it does cat piss.
It's got a lot going on. Not just like, you couldn't drink this all day. It's heavy. You couldn't just go out on the beach and listen to Megadeth and drink this all day.
At the beach? No, I wouldn't do that.
You'd be puking in a couple minutes, which I probably will be, because these are
definitely will be.
You're gonna be puking?
Yes. Man, we had to take an intermission, dude.
What?
It's packing in there. I ate too much chili.
Why the fuck would you do that?
I ate a lot of chili.
Why would you do that?
Is that a duck?
Who fucking do that?
Dude, we're drinking these beers, homie.
You knew we had a beer review, Derek! I would call this beer robust.
Yeah, it's robust. It's profound. It's got a lot going on for it. but it's not really still what I want. Let us know in the comments below, what's your favorite Megadeth song?
What's your favorite Megadeth song?
I always liked Tornado of Souls.
That's a good one, that's a good one.
Rest in peace.
Let's finish out these beers.
Oh man, no.
And get some more.
Our next beer here is the War Dance by Butternuts Beer and Ale. They're out of Garrettsville, New York.
I've never heard of Butternuts Beer and Ale.
Well, next time you're in Garrettsville, New York, stop by Butternuts and say hi.
I've
never been to Garrettsville.
This is a collaboration with the band Anthrax. War Dance is brewed using a blend of both New York State and North American two-row malt barley.
My dude.
And a blend of special malts to add color and depth of flavor. The result is a recognizable beer with a unique character, and it sets War Dance apart from other beers out on the market today. Wow, that's bold.
The can looks cool.
The can is very cool.
To see the can?
It's got like a chief.
Oh, cool, yeah.
Obviously inspired by the song Indians by Anthrax, which is one of my favorite songs.
Brewed by Metalheads. That's always a stamp of approval I like to see.
Cheers, boys.
Nope, that's a no for me, dog. Ooh. I'm out.
What does that taste like?
Bad. Definitely sets it apart in that it's not good.
I don't like this.
Two.
Derek, we had this in Chicago, remember?
And we were drinking, we had like a bunch of them.
We went and saw Kalma in Chicago at Reggie's and they had this on tap or something.
I don't like it.
We were slamming them. I don't remember it being this bad. War Dance!
I'm speechless. I don't like this. This is how I felt about how Derek felt about the last 2 beers.
Say something right now?
Yeah, this beer sucks.
Butternuts, why have you made my Polly so mad?
My Polly?
He's so upset. Jesus Christ.
So no for me.
This is not the reaction that people usually give when they don't like a beer. They just drink it all the way to the face. Don't like this.
Most people are not true American heroes.
Most people aren't Polly.
Yeah, that beer is not for me. I'll say that.
Well, on that note, I guess it's time to drink it all the way down.
Oh, Jesus. Well, Christ.
Derek, are you with me? Or are you with
me? I'm here. If you cheer me, I'm with you. Ready?
Cheers.
Oh, I have spicy gold. You're either in or you're out.
Derek is an in or out guy. And sometimes, as in previous beer reviews, he spills his beer all over the table and snorts it.
Snorts it like cocaine.
Which.
It takes a lot of beer to get to that point.
I'm proud of you for that. That's one of your best moments.
Next up, we have Iron Maiden's Trooper.
Yeah, baby.
This is a collaboration with Robinson's Brewery. They're out of Greater Manchester, England. Trooper is a premium British beer.
Premium.
Inspired by the Iron Maiden song of the same name.
Sounds very sweet.
Malt flavors, we got citric notes and a unique blend of hops, which dominate this deep golden ale with a subtle hint of lemon.
You can smell the malt, just...
Oh, dude, it smells super sweet. It smells English.
Yeah. Yep. It's like a Boddington's or something.
Wow. Newcastle?
It's pleasant. Whoa! Finally, something this boy likes.
That's pretty goddamn good.
Before craft beer was a thing, that's all you could find that was like obscure, like
what?
Oh, Newcastle, Boddington's, and all this kind of stuff. You're just like, oh yeah, this isn't Budweiser, this isn't, you know, Miller. You just try all these weird British beers, and this is a flavor that I'm familiar with, and I like it.
You take my life, but I'll take yours too. You fire my cigar, I'll run you through.
I would say this is one of the best beers of the night. Amazing. Cheers to that. Iron Maiden, fucking doesn't get any better than that.
It's definitely a strong lemon flavor.
You taste lemon?
Yes.
It tastes a little bit.
aftertaste.
Little bit, yeah. It's a good beer.
What do you give it? How many irons?
Three.
Up the irons to three. I give it a three.
If I'm rating it against the other beers, it's a 3.25.
Damn, it's Derek.
It's good.
Boy, know what he likes.
He's a man who knows what he likes.
We just finish these damn beers?
Dude, don't yell at me.
You're not my dad.
You're not my real
dude,
dad.
Dude, quit yelling at me, man.
I'm getting drunk.
We're going to keep the Maiden train going on this next one, you guys. With another Iron Maiden collaboration, this is the Sun and Steel Sake Lager.
This looks like Steel Reserve.
It does.
This can looks like a Steel Reserve can with Eddie on it.
I never had Steel Reserve. What is it?
Don't want it.
If you have Steel Reserve, I'm going to start worrying about your health.
Hey guys, Sun and Steel, it's a double fermented pilsner with a crisp, refreshing taste and sake-like notes. 2 years in the making for this project, blending creative thinking, British brewing excellence, and Japanese sake yeast to create a truly unique beer. Let's try it out.
So they're using the yeast from sake. Do you guys, have you ever had sake?
No.
No?
Yeah.
Rice wine?
Yeah.
I don't think so. Isn't it just horseshoes?
It's sweet.
Isn't it?
It's very sweet.
Oh, what? I hope it doesn't taste like Steel Reserve.
I hope it doesn't taste like sake.
Tastes like Kirin Ichiban.
It does.
Which I also can't
disagree with. Kirin Ichiban.
When you have some nice, a big sushi platter.
You're just thinking that because I said Japanese. You wouldn't have thought that if I
did. If you wouldn't have said that.
Blindfolded you.
I'm not feeling this one.
This one?
You don't like it? That's okay.
It's
too bland.
It's just a pilsner.
This is what the Metallica beer should have tasted like.
Yeah.
Right.
But yeah, this beer just kind of tastes like Budweiser a little bit. This is a chugging beer. You can drink this all summer long.
Mm-hmm.
You can drink this all summer long. You get wasted, jump off a pontoon, and shit your pants, throw up at your grandma. Nobody cares.
Sake! You ever see, you ever see Last Samurai?
Sake!
Tom Cruise is the Last Samurai. Will you just give him some sake?
That's a good movie. I enjoyed that. A lot.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. What would it take for someone somewhere in the world to make what we would consider the best beer on Earth? And someone answered that call.
They did.
Tell these good folks of the world what our beer is called.
All right, guys. We are very excited to finally announce the Astral Beer is real. So we teamed up with a local nano brewery called Grindhouse Brewing. This is our Eulogy in Black.
Baby.
With its dark as night color and malt forward flavors, it's brewed with unsweetened chocolate and an abundance of flaked oats for a full-bodied stout with decadent intensity.
Oh, shit.
Featuring a thick, rich, roasty mouthfeel and chocolate-heavy aroma, this beer pairs perfectly with the character and complexity of Astroborn's signature sound.
Did you write that?
Yeah.
Hell yeah!
I did
my dude!
Yeah. It's on the label, actually.
You know what? Fuck it. We got our own beer, man!
We got our own fucking beer!
So stoked! No, seriously, have you had this beer?
No, I haven't tried
it. None of us have had it, so it could be completely terrible. We have no idea. So this is the first sip. Let's do it together as a band. I'm so excited. Ready? Cheers to the Astroborn beer.
Oh, no.
I'm scared.
I'm afraid.
Dude.
God damn. That's some stank.
That's an ass kicker.
God damn.
Woo! With some stank on it. I will say.
How much did you drink when I first?
I'm stoked.
Tell me what you think. What's your first impression?
I taste bacon.
I really do.
Shut up, you're drunk. It tastes chocolate.
No, he nailed it.
Bacon.
He nailed it.
This
smoky.
Is Astroborn.
It tastes like the band.
I'm actually happy that it's good. Because I was super scared.
We weren't sure if it would be good.
I was super scared.
It could have sucked. And then what?
I could drink 300.
Let me taste it again.
Derek doesn't like it.
No, I like it. Derek, just let me make sure I understand it. Sometimes it's like a good album. You got to listen to it 3 times, and then you're like, well, okay.
Yeah,
okay.
You really got to splice.
Did you bring any more of those?
Yeah,
boys. See y'all later. I'm be gone. No, that's good.
Does it have a Doppelbach quality to it? Like a
little bit.
That's the vibe.
Doppelbach usually has like a black cherry undertone to it. This doesn't have that.
But it's got that smokiness. It tastes smoky.
I don't taste that.
No,
it tastes roasted.
Maybe I'm mistaken.
I think it's the chocolate.
Well, I'm gonna give that a 5 out of 5.
Yeah, man. We can't not give it a 5.
Yeah, it's good. It's just bad marketing.
It's good.
But fuck, we have our own goddamn beer.
Hey,
and on that note, we want to say thank you all so much for everything that's just gone on lately. We're super stoked to announce so many new things, and we're just happy to have our own beer finally.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
Beer, by the way, is not available for purchase. We got about a pound of this shit for us to drink.
Not for you, ladies
not for
and gentlemen.
You,
sorry,
we don't have a liquor license to sell it.
And if you want to buy it on the black market, it's $600 a bottle.
Yeah, DM us.
Woo! 10.5%.
Might be on to some.
Yeah! Boy! Thank you all. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Instagram, Facebook,
Untapped. Yeah, beer drinkers, we're on Untapped if you want to follow us.
Why are you not on Untapped?
Yeah, see us be alcoholics in real time.
And stay happy.
Hey, thanks for watching. We hope you enjoyed. Check out all of his beers in the description below. See what you think. And
cheers!